No, he's getting paid. Somebody's gonna have a big ass Brian ATV in the middle.
Oh no, where did he go? Underneath the car, around the car, somebody else's bed.
Chuck made it in? Bowman. Yeah.
Chuck has got some shit, huh?
Did you go all the way to the bottom of that? Did you go all the way to the bottom? But I'll tell you this, once you use that a handful of times, it's never as round as it really was, you know what I mean? That's when you gotta fuck, you know what I mean? It might be time to get another one. It doesn't really
that's
have a brake.
It's a European diamond.
I believe so.
How was the bearing on that?
Fine. I already showed it to Brandon.
Congrats to him.
Still pretty tight.
The first thing I did, I pulled it out and I looked at it and I was like.
Now move back into grudge racing, it looks like.
I don't know, dude.
Back into grudge racing.
There's
gotta be something
out of the
rack.
Yeah, it has to be. Hey, I was gonna take it out of the rack, but Alan brought that over here.
Yeah.
They told me to take it out.
Yeah, no, he came over here and said, I got a single if you want it, so.
Yeah. They told me to take it out of the rack, and I was gonna take it out of the rack. Let them make the decision.
Do you like that?
His motherfucker.
He's showing.
He sends me a video of flying past the car. And then he sends a meme of a guy getting drunk.
There's some guy dragging his old lady by her hair across the floor.
Oh, that's good stuff.
Didn't even waffle the oil ring.
But it's been oil in like the last 6-7 runs. But
really?
It's not like bad oil.
Flip it over, roll it over.
Oh.
No, I'm just looking to make sure it didn't waffle.
Yeah.
It didn't waffle.
Usually I stick with these bastards. Usually do.
Right out. I don't know what's in those fucking beans.
Ryan, you're still
familiar with that today. Why is
he
doing? He sends me my video of my last pass.
Uh-huh.
And after he sends a video of me in the last pass, then he shows a meme of a guy dragging his old lady into the goddamn house.
Like
getting drove.
Oh, shit.
See you guys.
Thanks for coming out.
Yes, absolutely.
See you tomorrow.
I wish somebody would.
What? Flashlight?
Didn't know if you were done or not, sir.
Yes.
We're just waiting for you to hone some more.
You want me to hone some more?
He's there.
Okay. Yeah. What's in?
That
tube over
here.
What's in?
That tube?
Yeah.
Ah, it's just a
syringe looking tube.
Oh, yeah. I got oil and what's called
too.
And the what?
Yeah, you know, actually, for stuff. Port.
Yeah, I'll try to get fluid, but
Job numbers are different, but I believe Bisson. Bisson was right.
Okay.
Well, you're confident. I like it.
Wiped it out with WD?
Yes. Okay. Oh, yeah, right on.
I thought they had to run.
Are you done for tonight?
I thought they was running some Damon and Kai.
Yeah, well, you know.
I'm done every night. It's way past. If you ask Ryan, it's way past my bedtime.
It is way past my bedtime.
Yeah. But that's coming from a guy that doesn't sleep ever. He's a vampire.
Sleeps every once in a
while. Yeah. Here's when he sleeps, is whenever we're not doing anything, and as soon as he sits down in a chair, he can say whatever he wants to, he falls right asleep.
In a chair?
Yeah.
Does it in the truck.
Yeah.
What do you do to it? Just smoking a little bit, just putting rings and shit in one hole.
Talking about the last
one. Exactly.
I know it.
In the hole.
Not really mean.
Key's hanging up. Be scared of it. No. <It's> fun. that whole 3 horsepower.
Be scared of that Honda power.
What kind of horsepower those have? Like 10? What's 110?
I got a
for the most part today. There's a lot of fans here. It's a little bit warm, but overall the weather's good. It's a little bit overcast, but we're excited. We've made some big changes to the car that I think are going to really improve. We've struggled a little bit towards the beginning of the year, but you know, I believe we've made some big changes to the car that's going to make us a top contender at this race.
Was he?
Yeah, Brody okay. was driving.
Brody was driving?
Yeah. Brody, you just outran Justin Swanstrom. What do you got to say to the camera?
Say booyah!
Say booyah! We
I say we Justin. Sign him right now.
Yeah, we sign him right now as a junior driver.
Absolutely.
Yeah. He's a good driver.
He's a good driver. Driver. He's a really good driver.
Yeah.
Ryan, good yeah, job, man. So, Drew, Justin Swanstrom, round one.
Justin
buddy.
Swanstrom, round one. You know, it's not a good draw for me. I mean, it's not a good draw for him. It's not a good draw for me, but we had to do to get around him. So, luckily, I think we got our race car back, and we're going to be a lot more competitive the rest of the season. So I'm looking more forward to that. Right now, every pass we've made at this track, it's just gone straight down, and it's gone down fast, and that's what we want.
Yeah, good. Hey, good job, Ryan. Hey, bud.
This side pulling over the hood, but Justin
was he should hurt Ada.
Yeah, he scattered the transmission. I just want to make sure.
We'll go over it. We'll get it all. We'll go over it.
Yeah, got off in the marbles in the middle, and I don't know how close he was. I thought he was right there. So I just lift back into him, and just trying to get it to the stripe, and it just turned this way. I tried to pull it back around.
They said you kind of like pull it.
Give me a second.
I'll tell you right now, that bitch is fast, because I know how fast we ran down low, and you pulled us. So, I mean, it's fast. You got it back right there.
Damn, I know.
I mean, we were running our best download numbers when we came here, and you just provided us. I'm there.
Thank you.
Smile. Come on, girl. Come on.
Where is the scale from here?
Because we don't want to fuck the trailer up and mess with the trailer. Because then you get to the shop, it's going to be a mess.
Yeah.
Versus doing open wing, just do a fork wing. So.
What, try to get it in the trailer?
Or if the thing needs to, or if the thing needs to go straight over there.
Brandon, you bring your laptop with you or is it in the car?
I can. Do we even want to put it in the staff?
You may go get it?
No, I don't think so. Christian,
or do we need fucking somebody run to the fucking shop and grab a fucking.
Obviously, Bobby's 5 minutes right here, so it's like. It's not a problem. I can pull it or if we can't pull it, no problem.
I'm just ready to get your enclosed and head to Atlanta. I say, we're going to end up going home, getting the enclosed, and taking it straight from here to Atlanta.
They're going to want to kick it off, like, pretty quick. I would say there's things we can do. I'm trying to think of how we can do it. Richard, like right now, I know this is sucks and everything. When I came on, it's leaking. And there's rain about 30 minutes away. Like this deal.
No? No rain?
No?
Bypass this?
Seriously? Man, it was like, well, I guess I'm speaking much less. I've seen it earlier.
No, it was, like, that's what everybody said it was supposed to.
I was thinking, man, if that's luck's on our side,
Hey, before you get back, do you want me to do anything at the table or whatever when he tries to unload there? Because there are going to be a fuck ton of people. Do we need to move?
Nah, I don't care. Let the people see it.
Do I need to move anything though?
No, we just need to get it in there. It's just going to be tough to get in that spot.
Can we get a
trailer? Is that it, Hob?
Yes, sir. Okay. Thank you.
What's today? Friday?
It is Friday.
Today is Friday.
All right, today's Friday. It is the week after Tulsa and the week before Idaho. A lot of y'all see me sitting in front of the fireball car. And a lot of people have been paying attention to the internet, and they realize that we brought this car out to test it on Sunday, right after the Tulsa race. For y'all that don't know, had a crash with the, got into the wall with the gray car, camo car, whatever you want to call it. War Machine, it's got a bunch of different names. And it was bad enough that it had to go to the chassis shop. I was perfectly fine. It was really, in my opinion, a relatively mild hit for how much damage it caused. I guess it just hit the wall just right. You know, when I got out of the car, I thought, well, hey, this won't be bad. Hopefully we can make next round. I'm sure we tore up the door and the quarter panel and stuff. And then I got out and saw the wheel hanging off the front of it and the strut hanging off of it. So I was like, anyway, we tore the thing up pretty good. So basically, pretty much on that night, which was Saturday, Ricky took off from Tulsa, got the truck and trailer, went home, got home at midnight or 1?
About
1 o'clock in the morning, while we're still at the races, picked up the truck. Zach went with you, didn't you? So it was you and Zach. Picked up the truck. Picked up the enclosed trailer, picked this car up, turned around, went back up to where we were at in Tulsa. Ricky got back right after the race wrapped up in Tulsa because it was a later race. Showed up, about 3:30 or 4?
3:30.
3:30 in the morning on Saturday. We all got a little bit of sleep, got up the next morning. We took this car out of the trailer. We put the camo car in the trailer. Ricky took off to Atlanta to head to the chassis shop with it, and we put this thing on Projacks and started messing with it to, because we knew this thing was going to have to take its place. So unfortunately, we had to call in a sub, but our sub's Old Faithful, right? So it's won us a championship before. This has currently all the spare parts out of the gray car in it. So it's got the same motor, same transmission, same rear diff. A little bit different weight package in this car than the other one. We got the other car down to a 27-25 with a smaller blower, and we're gonna have to run this one at 28-25 with the 140 Pro Charger. So we'll run the cars a tad bit different, but after testing on Sunday, this thing did really well. Kind of surprised us all, because we had been testing it in case the gray car didn't get done for the second half of the season. So it was kind of ready, but not exactly where we wanted it. But Sunday, it's back close to where we want it. So I've got faith that this car's gonna do good. I don't think this thing's quite as fast as the other car, but it's pretty damn close. Close enough that I still think it's possible to pull off a win with it. We'll just have to work a little harder, concentrate a little more. Petty will have to be on his game. I'll have to not crash it. That'd be a plus. But I feel pretty good about it overall. So this thing's ready, Hav. What'd you do? You changed the oil in this?
Changed the oil.
Changed the transmission fluid. Changed the blower oil.
Bled the brakes, because the brakes, you said, suck.
Yeah.
Put the ISP foam back in it, because when you street race, you took that out there. So we want you to continue to be safe.
Took a little bit of weight out of it.
Yeah, we took as much little bullshit out of it as we could.
Yeah. So
other than that, it's ready.
Yeah, he's just been kind of tinkering with it, just getting it ready to be on the road. The gray car is the chassis is either already fixed or almost fixed as of today. They got the quarter cut off of it. New quarter is basically set on it, but they haven't started attaching it yet. Next week for that car, they're gonna be doing all the body work. So the doors showed up for them today. The rocker showed up for them today. They've already got the front clip fixed in the car because it actually didn't get hurt that bad. And they got the new quarter on it. So once the body work gets done with that, which I'm suspecting will be late next week, that car will probably be back ready to go. I think we're gonna be in Idaho with this car and then right back into the other car with at Bandamir. So we'll see how that goes. And it depends on how this car does. You never know. A lot of people I know are excited to see this car back out, and look, we pull off a win with it or something like that.
You're crazy.
Might stick around, you never know.
You're crazy.
I wish we could get this car light like the other car, lighter like the other car, but as of right now, this car's about 50 pounds. When it's all said and done, 50 or 60 pounds heavier than the other car is. So we can't make that 27-25 weight with it. We've got to run it at 28-25. I think the lightest we could probably get this is if we just ditched everything and the headlights in the front and all that stuff. I think we could get it to about probably somewhere in the neighborhood of 27-60, 27-70, and that's still about 50 pounds too heavy for, in my opinion, for that 27-25 package. So we're gonna run it heavy. We're gonna run it with the bigger blower. And try to make Idaho and do as best we can. I think if it's consistent, we got a pretty good shot.
Yeah, it's that Sunday, that's the most consistent it's car been with this package in it.
Yeah.
Like you said, we went testing before and we didn't have a very good bug. So.
No, and a lot of the other NPK guys were at one of our Tulsa test sessions and it didn't go real great. So we didn't have a lot of faith in this thing until we really put our minds to it. And then Sunday we changed, Petty got up underneath there, changed the four link a little bit. I lowered the front of the car down where I thought that really it needed to be to start with, and it was just a totally different car. So
made four laps
in a row and consecutively faster every time.
In the heat of the day and terrible air.
Yeah, probably some of the worst air we've raced in yet.
Yeah, at a normal place, not anywhere like Colorado or Idaho.
Right. So we'll see. We'll update you guys again pretty soon, but I don't know. I think.
Back.
Yeah.
Subbed in.
A lot of people have been wanting to see it. Yeah. This is not how we wanted to bring it out, but here we go.
Come to Idaho, guys. Tickets available.
That's right. Come to Idaho. Tickets available on the boat. Tickets available at the gate. Richard, you're probably giving away tickets, huh?
Yep, always.
Yeah, call Richard. He'll give tickets away. I'll give you guys his number later. Ricky, anything to add? Got any tickets you're giving away to the Idaho race?
No, just ask about Rick. He's too busy driving.
Yeah. Driving. You're just driving, huh?
Yeah, he's driving.
Yeah.
I'm probably going to drive there, though.
Yeah. You're not going to drive there? You might. You never know.
Never mind. Take that over.
Yeah.
A lot of driving to do. So.
It's only 22 hours.
I'm sure. I'm sure it sounds like I'll get to do a lot of driving.
All right, so we're going to drop this thing off the open trailer, stick it in the stacker,
yeah, we should go ahead and hang this
out. And get loaded and ready to go because we're headed out Tuesday morning. Good.